Hi friends, welcome to our financial management class. We are going to study today the cost of capital. The entire cost of capital chapter, we will cover this chapter with all the formulas, with good examples and all the types of the sums which can be asked from the MCQ point of view. Okay, so the entire cost of capital chapter can be done from here, can be revised within an hour's time and it can be complete. Okay, so let's begin talking about cost of capital. When I am talking about cost of capital, I am talking from the company point of view. Okay, cost of capital. Company needs capital to run its business. Okay, so company has options to raise funds. That funds can be raised from various sources. Like we all know, company can raise equity share capital. Company can also provide preference share capital. They can have long-term debts like debentures or bank loans. Also, company keeps certain amount of the earnings with themselves, which they again reinvest in their various projects. Okay. So when capital is taken from the various sources, from more than one of these sources, and when the total cost of capital is calculated with the help of the weight, we term that as weighted average cost of capital, okay, which is denoted by K, cost of overall capital. It is denoted by word K, alphabet K. Okay. Now, cost of capital. It is, as I told you, it is the cost that the company incurs to raise money. Okay, it is the cost required to raise that money. So from the company point of view, it is the cost of the capital. But when I am talking about an investor, for the investor, it is the return. Okay, return on investment. Return on investment. Okay, so if a company is able to cover its cost of capital is at least, okay, it is at least the minimum return expected by the investors, then any kind of a project, okay, which is put up to the investors to raise the money will be accepted. Okay, will be accepted. Otherwise, if the return, okay, is less, if the cost of capital is more, then the return on investment, which is the minimum which is required by the investors, the project is rejected. Alright. Now, coming to understanding the cost of capital. Okay, so when a given cost of capital, okay, when a given project has to be accepted or whether the given project has to be rejected, we generally as a company try to find out its cost involved. Whether that cost is enough, okay, it is the benchmark, it is the hurdle rate, okay, to make our investors happy, minimum return they are getting on their investment, because if I am an investor and I am investing in the company, I would expect some kind of a return from the money I provide to them. Okay, so if the cost of capital is more and the company is not able to provide that minimum benchmark return, the projects will not be accepted, it will not be floated in the market. So whenever a money, okay, when the funds are to be raised from the market, we first find out the cost of capital and then we decide whether the project has to be done or no. Okay, now this cost, okay, when I'm talking about capital, I told that we have equity. So we have to find the cost of equity capital, of equity share capital. To equity shareholders, we provide them dividend. Okay, then we have preference shares. So the cost of preference share capital, again we provide them preference dividend. Okay, so that preference dividend for a company is a cost. If I'm talking about debentures or if I'm talking about loans, then my cost of debentures or long-term loans is nothing but in form of interest. So each of the source, okay, has a way, okay, has a formula to calculate the cost of capital, and when we calculate all together, we get the total cost of capital from all the sources. But before we move on to any of the formulas, we will just take an example of how to find a given cost of capital with the help of the amounts given. Okay, it is a very, very simple thing. Say suppose there is a company. Okay, company started a business with rupees 10 lakhs. So that is the capital employed. Capital employed with the company. Now that 10 lakhs, they have taken from various sources. One is equity, second is some debt, and third is preference shares. To debt, they're paying 10% interest, and to preference shares, since preference shares the dividend is fixed, they're paying 12% of preference dividend. The amount raised from equity is 5, from debt is 3 lakhs, and from preference shares it is 2 lakhs. They've already calculated my cost. Okay, cost of equity is denoted by word KE. Cost of debt is denoted by word KD, and cost of preference share is denoted by word KP. They have calculated this cost and already given to me. Debentures ka to yahan pe hi pata chal raha hai. Debt is 10%, interest and preference share is 12%, and they have calculated cost of equity and given to me. That cost is coming to, if I am taking 5 lakhs into 20% is 1 lakh, 3 lakhs into 10% 30,000, 2 lakhs into 12% 24,000. So total amount of cost which I have to pay on my 10 lakhs is 1,54,000. When I calculate the overall cost of capital will be nothing but the total cost upon the total capital, which is going to give me 15.4%. Okay. This is the most simplest, the most vanilla method of finding the cost of capital. Now the second way, okay, when we are talking about weighted average cost of capital, in which we assign weights. Same example we will take, okay, same amount of sources, 5 lakhs, 3 lakhs and 2 lakhs. When I have to assign the weights, I take the amount divided by the total. So here it is 5 divided by 10, 3 lakhs divided by 10 and 2 lakhs divided by 10, I get my weights. Cost of capital remains the same. Weights into cost, 0.5 into 20, 0.3 into 10 and 0.2 into 12, that will give me a direct answer on my weighted average cost of capital. So the project which will give me a yield above the cost, okay, if it is giving me a yield at around 18%, I will accept the project. But if the project, okay, is giving me a return of 12% only, but the cost is 15.4, cost is more than the return, then the project is going to get rejected. Okay, so this is the basic vanilla method of finding the weighted average cost of capital. Thus, the entire format, okay, to find the WACC remains the same throughout all the sums. Now, here, they had already provided me with the cost of each source of capital. But in the given sums, we have to find this cost. Okay, for which we have fixed formulas which are very simple to understand. Let's start with those formulas. And then we will take one example for each sum. Okay, starting with the cost of equity. Cost of equity, there is one formula which talks about the dividend method. When I am trying to find the cost with the help of dividend approach, okay, dividend method or dividend approach, because equity shareholders get dividend. So the formula will be D1 upon P0, KE will be equal to D1 plus P0, where D1 is the dividend, okay, for next year. For next period, because agar aaj main invest karungi to aaj dividend nahi milega, next time milega. And P0 is the price today, or I can also say as current market price. Okay, so this is the dividend approach. Similarly, cost of equity, can also be found with the help of growth approach. Growth plus dividend, both. Okay, in that case, KE will be nothing, the same formula, but with the growth percentage. Okay, so if they have given me that the growth given by the company, okay, on this equity, okay, is 8% or 10%, etc. So the growth percentage also will be added here. Next is cost of equity as per the earning per share. Earning per share method. Okay, or approach. In that case, cost of equity is nothing but earning per share upon the price today, current market price. Okay. Now, earning per share, sometimes people have this question that what is earning per share? Earning per share is nothing, but it is the net profit available for equity shareholders upon the number of equity shares. Total number of equity shares will give me my earning per share. Okay, so cost of equity, there are three different formulas based on what are they given in the question. We can use any one of the formulas. Next is cost of debt. Cost of preference shares, I'll finish. Cost of preference shares, we provide them preference dividend. So for the company, preference dividend is the cost upon the price, current market price today. Okay, but along with the preference dividend, the company also has to pay DDT. DDT is nothing but dividend distribution tax. ठीक है, तो कंपनी के लिए टोटल कॉस्ट क्या होगा? एक तो प्रेफरेंस डिविडेंड, उस पर डीडीटी देना है अपॉन द करंट मार्केट प्राइस. डीडीटी इफ इट इज गिवन वी विल टेक, इफ गिवन वी विल कंसिडर, इफ नॉट गिवन वी विल नॉट कंसिडर. ओके, एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज कॉस्ट ऑफ डेट. इन केस ऑफ कॉस्ट ऑफ डेट वी टेक द फॉर्मूला एज इंटरेस्ट. सिंस अ कंपनी पेज इंटरेस्ट ऑन द डेट, because of which that the profit of the company is less. When the profit is less, profit is reduced, even the tax is reduced. Thus, on interest, we always take the tax benefit. Okay. Tax benefit upon the price today. So, in a simplified method, 1 minus tax rate upon price today will be my cost of debt. Alright, so these are the three basic formulas. Also for the retained earnings, if nothing is provided for retained earnings, cost of R, it is same as cost of equity. Okay, cost of retained earnings is nothing but the same as cost of equity. Just taking a few examples of how to find this cost. Okay, let's start with this one small sum. This is all the theory which you all can go through. It is just reading. You all will be able to solve all the theory MCQs also. Okay, basic sums. Here they have given me a company wants to issue 12% debentures of rupees 100. The face value is 100. Tax rate is 25%. They have given me in parts. When they want to issue it at par means face value is the same as issue price. Here it is at a premium, that means issue price will be greater than the face value. Discount may issue price will be less than the face value. And last, 10% discount and 5% flotation cost. Okay, so just let's see question number one. Okay, we'll just write the given. In the given, it is we have to find cost of debt. The formula is interest 1 minus tax rate upon the current market price. Okay, so in A, interest is always, interest or dividend is always provided on the face value. Okay, interest or dividend is always given on the face value. interest or dividend always to be calculated on face value. Okay, so here the face value of my debenture is nothing but 100 on 100. If I'm taking 12%, it will be 12 rupees. And per share ke hisab se hame karna hai. So it will be 12, 1 minus tax rate. Tax rate is 25%. Upon the current market price. Now market price here, they have not given me market price, but they have given me four situations A, B, C, D. So one is at par. So the price also over here will be 100. Okay. So this will be 12 into 1 minus 0.25 upon 100. So my cost of debt will come to 9%. Now when I move further, okay, this cost of debt, interest 1 minus tax rate, the price is going to change. Why? Because here the price is PO for me is at a premium, 20% premium. 20% premium means 100 pay 20% more. So my price will now become 120. With 120 price, my cost of equity is going, cost of debenture is going to be 7.5%. Similarly, with C, interest 1 minus tax rate upon the price today, the price is going to be 20% discount. So 20% on 100. So here it became 120, here it is going to become 80. So since here it is 80, the cost of debt is coming to 11.25%. Okay, and in the last, at last, again same thing, interest 1 minus tax rate upon price. Price should be a proper exclusive price. Okay, it should be exclusive of all the other costs. Okay, so for me here, price will be at 10% discount. Okay, so 100 pe, agar main 10% discount lu to 90. So price should be 90 minus 5% of my flotation cost. 5% of 90 when I will do it, I will get 5%, I have to subtract from 90. Okay. 5%, so I'll get 85.5 as my price. So my cost of debt will now be 9.6%. Okay, so this was with the cost of debt. Okay, now say suppose I want to find it, I want to find cost of preference shares. Let's solve this sum. Preference shares of rupees 50, market price is 75, coupon rate is 15%. Okay, coupon rate means the dividend rate, interest rate, dividend rate. Okay, and tax is 20%. We have to calculate the cost of preference shares and cost of preference shares when there is a dividend distribution tax of 10%. Theek hai, we will solve this question number 3. Okay. Cost of preference shares, which I told is preference dividend plus DDT upon current market price. Preference dividend, they have told me it is 15% on 50. Okay, so 15% on 50 will come as 7.5. In part A, there is no DDT, so I will not write any DDT, and the current market price is 75. Okay, since this is always in percentage, we'll just multiply it by 100, we'll get 10%. And in case of B, we'll have 7.5 plus DDT, which is 10% upon 75, that will come to 11%. Okay, so this was with the case of cost of preference. And okay, one sum we will solve it with the help of cost of equity. See, the face value is 100, market price is 90. The dividend, okay, of the base year is 10, D1 is 10.5, we have to find KE. Okay, so question number 5, cost of equity, D1 upon PO plus the growth rate. Now here they have given me my D1. कितना दिया है मुझे D1? 10.5 upon my price they have given me is 90. Okay, plus my growth rate. Now what is my growth rate? Growth rate will be nothing but the difference D1 minus D upon the base. Okay, so it will be 10.5 upon 90 plus 5%. Okay, so here how will you solve is, you will first solve 10.5 upon 90 into 100, that will give you 11.67% plus 5%, that will give you 16.67%. Okay, so do not get confused here, just multiply this first by 100 so that you get this in percentage, because you can add percentage and percentage. Or else you can convert this percentage into number and then make it as a percentage. Okay. At the end of each sum, you have to remember that this cost are always in form of percentage. That is why we are multiplying it by 100 at the end. Okay. Now coming to. Okay. Another type of sum wherein we have to find the overall total cost of capital. Let's read this sum. Okay. Here they are saying that A and company has the following capital structure. They have debentures of 3 lakhs, 10% preference shares 2 lakhs, and their 5000 equity shares of rupees 100 each. So total is 10 lakhs. Now the equity shares of the company are quoted at rupees 102, so this becomes my market price. And the company is expected to declare a dividend of rupees 9 per share, that becomes my D1. Assuming the tax rate is 50%, we have to calculate the whole weighted average cost of capital. So let's see, let's begin question. Okay, I'll write my sources, I'll write my amounts, I'll write weights, I will have to find my cost of capital in percentage, and the last will be weighted average cost of capital. Now in sources I have equity. No, sorry. First is debentures, preference shares and equity share capital. So, I have my debentures, preference share capital and equity share capital. Okay, here I have 3 lakhs, 2 lakhs and equity is 5 lakhs. Total is 10 lakhs. How will I assign weight amount upon the total? So it will be 0.30, 0.20, 0.50. Now I am supposed to find the cost of capital. ठीक है तो पहले हम cost of capital ढूंढते हैं. पहले cost of debt, interest, 1 minus tax rate upon the current market price. Interest कितना दिया है हमें debentures के लिए? 10% on obviously rupees 100. Okay, if nothing is mentioned, I will take 100 as my face value. Okay, so here it will be 10, 1 minus tax rate 0.50 upon the current market price is to be 100. If nothing is mentioned, assume PO as 100, if nothing is mentioned. So I will get this as 5%. Okay, so mera cost of debt mujhe mil gaya. Second is cost of my preference shares. It will be preference dividend. DDT to hai nahi. Upon my current market price. Preference dividend. Kitna de rahe hum unko? 10%. Okay, market price kuch nahi diya hai. So I'll assume it to be 100. So this will also become 10%. And cost of equity is D1 plus price. Plus growth. Okay, D1 upon price plus growth. Now D1 they have provided me that the company is expected to give a dividend of rupees 9 and the market price is going to be 102. Aur growth ka kuch bhi nahi diya hai, to mera itna hi rahega. this directly I'll multiply by 100, I'll get 8.82%. I'll just put my weights here, or sorry, my cost over here. Okay, first one is 5. Don't write it in percentage form because obviously it is understood over here that it is percentage. Next one was 10 and the last one was 8.82. Just multiply and we'll get 1.5 to 4.41. So the total is coming to 7.91. That is my weighted average cost of capital. Okay, very very simple sums. Okay, once we are done with the finding of each cost of capital, weighted average cost of capital is the same format. Okay, now another type of sum wherein we have to find the weights as per the market value of the source. Okay, let's do this sum. We have been given determine the weighted average cost of capital using book value weights and second market value weights. Book value ka structure diya, debentures, preference shares and equity shares, and their market price is also given of debentures, preference shares and equity shares. Now how many debentures here I have? 8 lakhs divide by 100, 8000 debentures. Here I have got 2000 preference shares and I have 1 lakh equity shares. So when I will be doing as per my market price, basically I'll have to do 8000 into 110, 2000 into 120 and 1 lakh into 22. They have already calculated the cost of each component and provided to me. I have to just find the weighted average cost of capital by both the methods. Okay, so now starting with book value weights. Book value weights. Now when I'm doing book value weights, same thing, sources. Okay, I have amount, I'll assign the weights. Cost of capital they have calculated. I will be finding my weighted average cost of capital. Okay, so now in sources, I have a debentures, preference and equity. Debentures, preference share capital and equity share capital. Debentures, I'm doing book value method, 8 lakhs, 2 lakhs and 10 lakhs. 8 lakhs, 2 lakhs and 10 lakhs. Total is 20 lakhs. When I will assign them the weights, okay, I have to just assign weights on them. So 8 upon 20 I will do. That will be 0.40. Then preference share will be 0.10 and equity will be 0.50. Cost of capital they have already given it to me, 7.04, 17 and 14.87. Okay. So cost of debenture is 7.04. Okay, so 7. Don't write it in percentage. This cost of preference is 14.87 and cost of equity is 17. I'll just multiply both. I'll get 2.816, 1.487 and this will be 8.5. The total will be 12.803% weighted average cost of capital as per the book value method. Okay, same thing, now I have to just do it with the help of market value weights. Okay, market value weights. Okay, in case of market value, same thing, I'll write my sources, that is my debentures, preference share capital, equity share capital. But here are the amounts. Okay, with amounts I have to be careful. My amounts in case of debentures will now be 8000 into 110 because I have to do market value. 8,80,000. Here it will be 2000 into 120 which will be 2,40,000. And 1 lakh into 22 that will be 22 lakhs. So the total now will turn up to 33,20,000. I have to assign weights as per the market value. So it will be 0.2651, 0.72, no, this is 0.0723, 0723 and this is 0.6627. Cost will remain the same in percentage. Okay, so the first is 7.04, then 14.87, and this is 17, weighted average cost of capital, 1.87, 1.075, and 11.265. So the weighted average cost of capital is coming to 14.21. Okay, so if they are telling you market value weights ke hisab se karna hai, toh we will take the amounts as per the market value, the amounts. Okay, only this is going to change. Okay, now coming to one different types of sums. Now all these are just the practice sums. Okay, they can ask you about the combined questions. Okay, let's see what is this question number 13. Okay, this is like an overall revision. The Novex company has the following capital structure. They have shares, 4 lakh shares, 10% preference shares and 14% debentures. Total is 1 crore 60 lakhs. The share of the company sells for rupees 20. It is expected that the company will pay next year a dividend of rupees 2 per share, which will grow at 7% forever. Tax rate is 40%. You are required to compute weighted average cost of capital based on the existing capital structure. अभी जो capital structure दिया है उसके ऊपर weighted average cost of capital करना है. Compute new weighted average cost of capital if the company raises an additional 40 lakh debt by issuing 15% debentures. This will result increasing the expected dividend to rupees 3. पहले 2 था, अभी dividend 3 हो जाएगा. Level of growth will remain unchanged, but the price of that share from 20, it is going to fall to rupees 15 per share. Also in C, compute the cost of capital in B. Above, the growth is to increase to 10%. Okay, so instead of 7, we will take growth rate as 10%. पहले existing capital structure करते हैं, solve किया हुआ है ये सब. सिर्फ हमें देखना है. ओके, तो ऑर्डिनरी शेयर्स हैं अपने, टोटल दिया हुआ है अपने ऑर्डिनरी शेयर्स का 80 लाख. देन आई हैव माय 10% प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स एंड आई हैव माय 14% डिबेंचर्स. दिस इज माय एग्जिस्टिंग कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, व्हाट इज द कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल? ओके, कॉस्ट ऑफ माय शेयर विल बी हाउ मच? कॉस्ट ऑफ माय इक्विटी, it will be D1 upon price plus the growth rate. D1 they are going to give me 2 rupees, price is going to be 20 rupees diya hai, and the growth is going to be 7%. So here it will be 10% plus 7%, which is equal to 17%. Agar tumhe is percentage form mein nahi likhna hai, then you can write 0.17. And then later on convert it into percentage, or write 17 only directly here. One and the same thing. 10% preference shares, preference dividend वगैरह तो कुछ है ही नहीं, तो 10% ही रहेगा. Debentures का cost change होगा. It will be interest 1 minus tax rate upon the current market price. Okay. अभी interest is 14%, tax rate दिया है 40%. Upon the market price is 100. So this will come to 8.4%. तो या तो तुम 8.4 लिखो, okay, or else you can write 0.084 divide by 100 करोगे तो 0.084 आएगा, okay? When I will multiply this with the help of the weights, weights will be amount, okay, amount upon the total. So here it will be 80 lakhs upon 1.6 crores. Here 20 lakhs upon 1.6 crores and 60 lakhs upon 1.6 crores. I multiply weights and the cost. Then I multiply this by 100, I'll get 12.9%. Okay, this was with the existing capital structure. Now when I do a new capital structure, in that I'm going to raise more 40 lakhs of debt. How? By giving 15% debentures. ठीक है, तो देखते हैं अपना क्या है. ओके, विद द न्यू कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चर तो अभी एक और बढ़ जाएगा. तो ऑर्डिनरी शेयर्स था, प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स था, 14% डिबेंचर्स भी था, लेकिन ये बढ़ गया, ये न्यू है. ठीक है 80, 20, 60 and 40 इज एडिशनल, सो 2 crores. वेट्स पहले असाइन कर लो, ये इजी है, ठीक है. वेट्स जैसे असाइन कर लिया, लेकिन अभी नाउ माय कॉस्ट ऑफ इक्विटी विल चेंज. व्हाई? बिकॉज दे सेड दैट व्हेन यू विल डू दिस एडिशनल रेजिंग, ओके, ऑफ द शेयर्स, सॉरी ऑफ द डिबेंचर्स, योर डिविडेंड D1 अपॉन P0 प्लस ग्रोथ, ओके, योर डिविडेंड इज नाउ गोइंग टू बी, सी डिविडेंड विल बी 3, ग्रोथ विल रिमेन सेम, बट योर शेयर प्राइस विल फॉल टू 15. सो योर आई विल से डिविडेंड विल बी 3, बट शेयर प्राइस विल फॉल टू 15 एंड ग्रोथ विल बी 7%. व्हेन आई विल डू दिस आई विल गेट टोटल 27%. ओके, सो ऑर्डिनरी शेयर्स, प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स तो वही रहेगा, DDT नहीं है तो 10% ही रहेगा. डिबेंचर्स हमने ऑलरेडी पहले ढूंढ लिया है, और ये डिबेंचर्स का वापस ढूंढने नहीं है. कॉस्ट ऑफ डिबेंचर्स इज नथिंग, इंटरेस्ट 1 माइनस टैक्स रेट अपॉन द प्राइस. इंटरेस्ट इज 15, टैक्स रेट इज 40, आई गेट 9%, 0.09. माई वेटेड एवरेज कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल विल बी 16.1%. ओके, देन अगेन विद द सेम सम वी हैव टू जस्ट डू द चेंज इन द कॉस्ट ऑफ इक्विटी. वाई? बिकॉज दे आर सेइंग दैट इफ द ग्रोथ रेट बिकम्स 10%, देन वॉट विल बी माई न्यू वेटेड एवरेज कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल. सो ओनली माई कॉस्ट ऑफ इक्विटी विल चेंज हियर, इट विल बिकम 30%. ओके, सो दिस इज द बुक वैल्यू वेट्स वी हैव डन टू फाइंड द वेटेड एवरेज कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल. Now I would like to do one another sum, okay, which is a little different, wherein we'll find the market price. Okay, so let's start with this sum. Question number 17. Shares of Alpha Limited are currently being quoted at a price earning ratio of 7.5 times. The retained earnings of the company being 37.5% is rupees 6 per share. ओके, उसके पहले एक कॉन्सेप्ट समझते हैं कि जो भी नेट प्रॉफिट होता है. ओके, आई जस्ट राइट द इनकम स्टेटमेंट फॉर यू ऑल फर्स्ट. ओके, से दिस इज द इनकम स्टेटमेंट. इट इज अ वेरी ईजी कॉन्सेप्ट और लाइफ टाइम के लिए इसको समझना है. मैं बोलती हूँ कि मेरा नेट प्रॉफिट बिफोर इंटरेस्ट एंड टैक्स है 1000. उस पर मुझे इंटरेस्ट देना पड़ा था 200 rupees. सो नाउ आई एम लेफ्ट विथ 800 rupees नेट प्रॉफिट बिफोर टैक्स. ओके, नाउ माई टैक्स रेट इज से 50%. ओके, सो 400 हो गया मेरा टैक्स. सो नाउ आई एम लेफ्ट विथ 400 rupees एज नेट प्रॉफिट आफ्टर टैक्स. अभी नेट प्रॉफिट आफ्टर टैक्स में हमें जनरली पहले प्रेफरेंस डिविडेंड निकालना पड़ता है. पहले उनको डिविडेंड जाता है बिकॉज डिविडेंड इज फिक्स्ड. से आई एम पेइंग देम 200 rupees एज डिविडेंड. सो नाउ आई एम लेफ्ट विथ बैलेंस ऑफ 200 विच इज नोन एज नेट प्रॉफिट फॉर इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर्स. ओके, तो अगर मैं तुम्हें बोलूँ कि मुझे अर्निंग पर शेयर ढूंढनी है एंड नंबर ऑफ इक्विटी शेयर इज 100. ओके, सो देयरफॉर आई विल से अर्निंग पर शेयर विल बी नथिंग बट 200 rupees विच इज द अमाउंट अवेलेबल फॉर इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर्स अपॉन नंबर ऑफ इक्विटी शेयर्स. अर्निंग पर शेयर विल बी रुपीज 2 पर शेयर. ये अर्निंग पर शेयर. जब भी कंपनी के पास ये प्रॉफिट आता है, नेट प्रॉफिट अवेलेबल टू इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर्स, तो वो लोग डिसाइड करते हैं कि अभी ये जो पैसा है उसका क्या करना है. उसका डिविडेंड देना है या तो फिर उसको रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स में डाल देना है. रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स, रिजर्व्स एंड सरप्लस, इसमें डाल के फिर बाद में यूज़ करना है, क्या करना है. ओके, वैसे वो लोग एक डिसीजन लेते हैं. कोई कोई लोग सिर्फ रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स में पूरा का पूरा डाल देते हैं, थोड़े लोग पूरा डिविडेंड दे देते हैं. सर्टन कंपनीज से कि नहीं, थोड़ा डिविडेंड दे देते हैं. 200 में से सोचो 100 डिविडेंड दे देते हैं और 100 रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स में रखते हैं. ओके, सो दिस इज अ डिसीजन टेकन आफ्टर अराइविंग एट द नेट प्रॉफिट फॉर इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर्स. अभी ये सम में मुझे उन्होंने ऐसा ही कुछ बोला है. दे आर सेइंग दैट द प्राइस अर्निंग रेशियो इज 7.5 times. फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज प्राइस अर्निंग रेशियो? ओके, प्राइस, प्राइस मीन्स द मार्केट प्राइस. अर्निंग मीन्स द अर्निंग पर शेयर. दे हैव गिवन मी 7.5 times. ठीक है, प्राइस अर्निंग रेशियो इज 7.5 times. वट डज दिस मीन, यानी मुझे इतनी बार 7.5 times अर्न करना पड़ेगा इन ऑर्डर टू रीच द मार्केट प्राइस टूडे. सो देयरफॉर दे से अर्निंग पर शेयर, प्राइस अर्निंग रेशियो लेसर द बेटर, लेसर द बेटर. बराबर है ना, मुझे अगर ये अगर दो बार में ही मेरा मार्केट प्राइस रिकवर हो जाता है विथ माई अर्निंग, आई विल बी मोर हैप्पी. बट इट इज गोइंग टू टेक मी 7.5 times टू अर्न इन ऑर्डर टू रीच द मार्केट प्राइस टूडे. ओके, जस्ट अ कैलकुलेशन, अ रेशियो. नाउ दिस तो दे आर गिविंग मी 7.5 times एंड दे आर टेलिंग मी दैट द रिटेन अर्निंग्स इज 37.5% विच इज कमिंग टू ₹6 per share. ठीक है, तो अभी ये जो अर्निंग होती है, ओके, अर्निंग पर शेयर जो मैंने आपको यहाँ पे बताया कि ये भाई ये नेट प्रॉफिट है फॉर द इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर्स, उसमें से अर्निंग्स में से क्या किया है, रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स में डाल दिया. रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स में दे हैव पुट 37.5% ऑफ द अर्निंग्स, ओके, विच इज कमिंग टू ₹6 per share. सो डिविडेंड कितना दिया होगा इन दैट केस, 62.5%. ये जो पूरा अर्निंग है 100, ओके, 100% अर्निंग होता है, उसमें से ही मैंने बोला डिसीजन लिया जाता है, थोड़ा डिविडेंड देते हैं, थोड़ा रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स में डालते हैं. इन लोगों ने रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स में 37.5% डाला है, विच इज कमिंग टू ₹6. ओके, सो वॉट विल बी 62.5% कमिंग अप टू, इट विल बी ₹10. जस्ट क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई, दैट मीन्स डिविडेंड इज 10, रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स इज 6, देयरफॉर अर्निंग पर शेयर इज टोटल 10 + 6 विच इज 16. ओके, सो अर्निंग पर शेयर मुझे मिल गया, मेरा प्राइस अर्निंग रेशियो भी उन्होंने मुझे दिया है विच इज 7.5 times, मार्केट प्राइस मुझे पता नहीं है, अर्निंग पर शेयर मुझे पता. ओके, सो मार्केट प्राइस अपॉन अर्निंग पर शेयर इज 16. 7.5 × 16 विल गिव मी माई मार्केट प्राइस विच इज इक्वल टू ₹120 per share. अभी ढूंढना क्या है, कंप्यूट कंपनीज कॉस्ट ऑफ इक्विटी इफ द ग्रोथ रेट एक्सपेक्टेड इज 8%. ईजी है, तो अभी कॉस्ट ऑफ इक्विटी तो हम कर ही सकते हैं. कॉस्ट ऑफ इक्विटी का फॉर्मूला लिखेंगे, D1 प्लस करंट मार्केट प्राइस प्लस ग्रोथ रेट. डिविडेंड कितना है, कितना देने वाले हैं डिविडेंड हम, ग्रोथ रेट इज 8% है ना, और मेरा D0 मैंने जो फाइंड किया था वो ₹10 था. देखो यहाँ पे है ना, ₹10 था मेरा डिविडेंड, वो D0 है, बेस डिविडेंड. ओके, उस पर इफ आई एम पुटिंग 8% ग्रोथ रेट, ये करना ही पड़ेगा. जनरली D1 दिया हुआ रहता है, यहाँ पे D1 नहीं दिया, D0 दिया है. ओके, सो दिस विल बिकम 10.8. सो माई डिविडेंड फॉर द नेक्स्ट ईयर विल बी 10.8 अपॉन माई करंट मार्केट प्राइस विच आई फाउंड इज 120 एंड माई ग्रोथ रेट इज 8%. सो दिस इज गोइंग टू कम एज 9% प्लस 8% विच इज इक्वल टू टोटल 17%. ओके, सिमिलरली दे आर आस्किंग अनदर क्वेश्चन इन द सेम सम, that if the growth rate is 10% per annum, compute the market price with the same cost of capital. Okay, so they are saying same cost of capital pe, okay, and the growth rate they are saying it is 10%. Therefore, mera D0 tha ₹10, to D1 kitna ho jayega 10% pe, 11, ₹10 pe 10%. कॉस्ट ऑफ इक्विटी दे आर सेम, कीप इट सेम 17%. D1 मुझे पता है 11 है, मार्केट प्राइस नहीं पता है, ग्रोथ रेट मेरा है 10%. 17% माइनस 10%, ओके, विल बी 11 अपॉन मार्केट प्राइस, दैट विल बी 7% इज इक्वल टू 11 अपॉन मार्केट प्राइस. Therefore, market price is nothing but 11 upon 7%. That is going to give me 157.14 rupees per share. Alright, so these kinds of sums can be also asked wherein they are asking you to find one of the missing variable from the given formula. Okay. Now with all this, there is one very small last part which is left, wherein they have given you life of debentures and preferentials. Why life? Because these two types of the capital are redeemable in nature. So today, if I am telling you that I had issued debentures at rupees 100, but tomorrow I am going to give them rupees 120, redemption value. That means I am going to give them 20 rupees extra. Premium dungi main redemption ke time pe. So don't you think this 20 rupees is the cost to the company? Additional cost. But ये एडिशनल कॉस्ट हर साल नहीं है, ये एक ही बार का है. एंड मैं तुम्हें अगर ऐसा बोलूँ दैट द लाइफ ओके मीन्स इन हाउ मेनी ईयर्स आई एम सपोज टू रिडीम, 5 years है, तो ये पूरा 20 जो है पूरे 5 years में डिवाइड हुआ है. सो व्हेन अ लाइफ ऑफ डिबेंचर इज गिवन एंड द रिडेम्पशन वैल्यू इज गिवन, देन माई फॉर्मूला चेंजेस अ लिटिल बिट. ओके, देन इन दैट केस ओके माई फॉर्मूला विल बी कॉस्ट ऑफ डिबेंचर्स वही रहेगा पहले, इंटरेस्ट 1 माइनस टैक्स रेट, ठीक है. बट अभी रिडेम्पशन वैल्यू माइनस द इश्यू प्राइस और द सेल्स वैल्यू अपॉन द एन, दिस मीन्स 120 माइनस 100, जो 20 रुपीज प्रीमियम दे रही हूँ मैं, अपॉन एन, एंड द प्राइस हियर विल बी द एवरेज ऑफ रिडेम्पशन वैल्यू प्लस द इश्यू प्राइस और द सेल्स वैल्यू अपॉन 2. ओके, एस वी इज नथिंग बट द इश्यू प्राइस और यू कैन ऑल्सो से सेल्स वैल्यू. ओके, एट द प्राइस एट विच इट वॉज इश्यूड. एंड आर वी इज नथिंग बट द रिडेम्पशन प्राइस. ओके, सेम थिंग इट इज विद द प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स. द फॉर्मूला विल रिमेन सेम, प्रेफरेंस डिविडेंड ओके प्लस डी डी टी जो हम करते हैं उसके साथ में ही. Okay, but here it will be again plus redemption value minus sales value upon N, and the whole thing will divide by the average price of the preference shares. Okay, so if in case in the sum they have given you, okay, that there is these debentures are redeemable say in a period of 10 years or 5 years, then accordingly my formula will change. Okay. Let's see, we can just have a look at one sum over here. Okay, a company wants to issue debentures at rupees 100 each. Okay, issue price is 100, issue value. They are going to carry interest 10% and life N is given me 10 years. Calculate, and tax rate is 30%. Calculate DB if issued 10% at discount and redemption will be at par. ठीक है, ओके. नाउ लेट्स सी दिस, फेस वैल्यू इज 100. इन केस ऑफ ए दे आर सेइंग दैट द इश्यू इज अ 10% डिस्काउंट, देयरफॉर इश्यू प्राइस विल बिकम 90 रुपीज एंड रिडेम्पशन प्राइस इज एट पार, दैट मीन्स रिडेम्पशन विल बी एट 100 रुपीज. सो नाउ माई फॉर्मूला विल बी इंटरेस्ट 1 minus tax rate plus RV minus SV upon 2, sorry, upon N. The whole thing divided by RV plus SV upon 2, average. Okay, so interest is 10%, 1 minus tax rate is 0.30 plus redemption price is 100. I'm going to redeem at par, but my issue price was 90 because I issued at discount and number of years is 10. This will be 100 plus 90 upon 2. Okay, so when I'll calculate this, I have to just multiply. Okay, so 10 into 0.7 That will give me 7. Solve it here and just solve it over here. Fresh. Okay. Question number 7. Cost of debenture will be interest 1 minus tax rate plus RV minus SV upon N, the whole thing upon RV plus SV upon 2. Interest is 10 minus tax rate is 0.30. Redemption price is 100. Issue price was 90 upon 10. And the whole thing divided by 100 plus redemption price is 90. Sales value 100 upon 2. 100 plus 90 upon 2. Now this will come to 10 into 0.7 plus 10 divided by 10 will be 1 upon 190 divided by 190 divided by 2. That will be 95. So this will be 8 upon 95 percentage. 8 divided by 95%, the answer will be 8.42% will be my cost of debentures when my life of the debenture is given. Alright, so with this we complete the entire cost of capital. Each type of sums you all can solve, okay, with regards to the basic solving of, you know, where the amounts and cost is already given, you can directly find the total cost of capital. When the cost of equity is to be found, cost of debentures, cost of preference shares, each type of basic sums we did. Weighted average cost of capital with the help of book value, with the help of market value weights. And the combined question wherein you have to find the cost as well as the weighted average cost of capital. And this was a just a little bit new in which the cost of debentures will change, cost of preference shares will change if their life and their redemption price is provided to us. Okay, thank you so much for listening to me, and you can also subscribe to our channel, okay, for any further updates on the same subject on financial management. Thank you.